In this video lesson, I will show you how an industrial machine works, in this case, a pallet wrapping machine. I will also present the project assumptions based on which your task will be to select the devices for the control cabinet. Alright, we already have the solid model that we received from the mechanical designers. As you can see, our designers have a good sense of humor.
Oh my god, what's happening now?
But that's not the most important thing here. Our task will be to design the control cabinet for this station. Already from this model, we can initially determine the drives. We have the power ratings and the initial setup of the sensors. We need to prepare our control cabinet to handle the proper number of digital and analog signals. How does this station work? It's a pallet wrapper. As you can see, we have three roller conveyors here, entry conveyor, central conveyor, and exit conveyor. Here we have an example of such a roller conveyor. In the middle, there is a turntable, which is used to rotate the pallets and wrap them in foil, like that on the sample video. Here is the head that dispenses the foil, the so-called foil dispenser. It has the ability to move up and down. We'll use a servo for this axis, so we should already account for that. Here, this block is responsible for tearing the foil. There's nothing here yet, but later, we'll install the proper pneumatic mechanism, which will generate the necessary tearing of the foil on the pallet. If you are enjoying the content on automation and robotics, make sure to subscribe and leave a like on the video. Now, I'll show you how to analyze the layout of an industrial machine. You can find the complete electrical schematic in our industrial automation basic course, available in PDF format on our e-learning platform through the link below the video. In the electrical diagram of the pallet wrapping machine, on page 4 you will find the layout of the workstation. You can now open this diagram and analyze it with me. This schematic represents the layout of the pallet wrapping machine. The diagram is divided into several key sections. Entry conveyor, function F2, located on the left side of the schematic. This section depicts the entry point where pallets are initially placed onto the conveyor system. This is the starting point of the wrapping process. Central conveyor, function F3. The middle section shows the central conveyor where the actual wrapping occurs. This part of the machine includes the wrapper head that moves around the pallet to apply the wrapping material. Exit conveyor, function F4. On the right side, the exit conveyor is displayed. This is where the pallets are transferred after the wrapping process is complete, ready to be moved to the next stage in the production line. Main electrical cabinet, A1. This represents the main control unit of the machine, housing critical components such as PLCs, relays, and power supplies that manage the operation of the entire system. Wrapper control cabinet, Area 2. This cabinet is dedicated to controlling the wrapping functions, ensuring precise and efficient operation of the wrapper. Station and equipment. This is the overall station layout, an overview of the physical setup, including the conveyors and control cabinets. This schematic provides a clear, top-down view of the machinery and its components, showing how the electrical and mechanical parts are interconnected. This visual representation is crucial for understanding the workflow of the machine and ensuring that all components are correctly integrated into the system. Let's start with the next part of our tutorial. I'm going to show you how to read and interpret a specific part of the electrical schematic for a pallet wrapping machine using both the machine layout and the detailed section of the schematic. On the left slide there is machine layout. Here we see the layout of the pallet wrapping machine. The system is divided into three main sections: the entry conveyor, the central wrapping unit, and the exit conveyor. The labels F2, F3 and F4 correspond to these sections respectively, which will help us match components in the schematic to physical locations on the machine. In the schematic, we see references like plus A1 main electrical cabinet. This tells us that all the components shown on this page of the schematic are located in the control cabinet labeled as plus A1. If we have a situation where some components are located in a different area, we label them accordingly. Here we have an example. The motors are located in the area labeled plus A3 station and equipment. Each conveyor drive is represented here by a motor, symbol M, and the specific motors are labeled equal F2, M20, equal F3, M21, and equal F4, M22, corresponding to the entry, central, and exit conveyors. These labels directly link the schematic to the physical conveyor sections in the layout. Let's explain motor switches and their functions. The motor switches labeled S equal F2 Q20, equal F3 Q21, and equal F4 Q22 are shown in the top of the schematic. Their role is to protect the motors by interrupting the power supply in case of overload or fault. The components are grouped functionally in the schematic: F2 for the entry conveyor, F3 for the central conveyor, and F4 for the exit conveyor. Motor switches are of course located in the control cabinet, which is in the plus A1 area, as we can read from the schematic. By understanding the layout and matching it with the schematic, you can quickly identify where each component is located and what its function is within the machine. This method is essential for troubleshooting and maintaining the system effectively. Let's go to our PDF file with a 3D model for control cabinet. Inside the control cabinet, you can find a lot of industrial automation components. Like here, we have motor switches for conveyors. Each component is labeled with a sign. Here we have a labeled motor switch. On the left, we have F2 function, which is the entry conveyor, plus A1, which is area. In that case, this is area 1. It means that that component is inside the control cabinet. And in the end, we have a code for a specific component. Here we have Q20, which is motor switch. Next, we have motor switch for the central conveyor. And the last one for the exit conveyor. I'd like to show you one more example that will clear up any remaining doubts and help you navigate the project with ease. On page number 7 of the electrical schematic, there is a symbol for a power supply. It is labeled with the symbol G1 and does not have an additional function symbol. In such cases, it is automatically assigned to the function and area listed at the bottom of the schematic, which in this case are F1 function, which is main function, and plus A1 area. If you look at the 3D model of control cabinet, you can find the power supply. It has the label equal F1, which means it is assigned the default function area and the designation G1, indicating it is the power supply. Okay, that's everything for this video. I hope you now know how to read an electrical schematic and compare it with the labels on the devices in the control cabinet. Thank you for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more content on industrial automation and robotics. Leave a comment below if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos. See you in the next one.